So this is powertrain at its core, as raw as it gets. A lot of wiring in this new model. So it's, yeah, it's taken a long time, but we're getting there.
I keep referring back to the vehicle from my extensive history at McLaren Automotive, Tom Walkinshaw Racing, Brabham, and also volume automotive manufacturers. However, the requirements to fly are significantly more stringent than those I have applied in automotive. Many of the tools and processes are common, but this is another level. We're taking a systems-based approach to deliver a design with high levels of redundancy to ensure that no single fault can lead to loss of the primary function, that is controlled flight. We're making increased use of simulation, hardware in the loop, and also formal integration testing to ensure that we're delivering ever-increasing levels of safety. Proving these systems on the Mark III brings us closer to having a pilot on board with the future Airspeeder. If any of the systems were to fail on the vehicle, the redundant architecture and the fault handling ensure that the vehicle remains controllable in the air, albeit with reduced performance.
The levels of safety that we now have in the powertrain is just going up by magnitudes, so we're monitoring things so much more closely now.
All systems are monitored by telemetry. This means that the crew operating the vehicle are immediately alerted to any issue and can take the appropriate response to land the vehicle in a safe location. The controls required to deliver this level of functionality are very complex and require a rigorous level of testing to verify their function at a subsystem level.
Out of everything that we do here, batteries are always the limitation. With the flight times being shorter, we need to be able to come down and really efficiently and safely swap out the batteries with very little infrastructure or fasteners.
A huge amount of work has gone into that battery. We've gone through a few stages of development, a lot of design work, a lot of CAD work, and then a lot of building and testing, and getting to the point of developing better methods of testing, better methods of building, so that we know that that battery is not going to be the failure point in the system.
Contact.
Contact.
Open circuit. Contact.
Contact. Open circuit. Yeah, I love the aesthetic. I've got to say, like, I put a lot of effort into the design of the battery, and aesthetic was not my design goal, but I think anybody who looks at the battery can see that aesthetic was a consideration. Sport has a huge influence on our design. Electric vehicles on the road have to be charged. So the vehicle itself has to be charged because the battery is integrated into that system. Whereas we want to drive really high power, really quickly, we're going to run out of battery and deplete that battery. We don't want to have people jumping out of vehicles to race multiple vehicles. We want to be able to switch those batteries out. So that's a huge proponent of what we've done with this design. These batteries slide in on the rails and lock in on those electrical connections. And then we also have additional mechanical connections as a safety feature, but the idea eventually is to get to the point where I push that battery into the vehicle, that's ready to go.
With current battery technology, we are limited in terms of how much, if you like, energy per kilogram we can put in the vehicle. Come with other electric vehicles, the energy density is a limiting factor for the performance of the vehicle. We want to be able to support racing, and to do that we need to change the battery in order to achieve that race performance and also achieve the time in the air. This then can become a strategic option, a strategic advantage for the teams, how they manage the depletion of the batteries and when they choose to change batteries. This is also affected, by the circuit, and that different circuits will have a different energy requirement. Teams may find that it's advantageous for certain tracks to employ full performance and schedule the maximum number of batteries for that race. Other teams may decide that it's better to manage the power use and actually look for a longer period between battery changes. These certainly are possibilities, and when we start flying, we can then test out some of these strategies and see how the vehicles respond to these kind of variables.
Airspeeder is a high-performance manned eVTOL air race taking place in remote locations all over the world. Race environments will include harsh deserts, frozen tundra, tropical coastlines, and everything in between. A race will typically include anywhere from 2 to 10 aircraft racing in close proximity. This is motorsport in the sky. The speeders will race in a three-dimensional circuit, stopping regularly at several pit stop locations to swap batteries. As well as receiving a fresh battery at the pit stops, the speeders will have the opportunity to also alter their battery or propeller configurations, allowing them to shift the aircraft's balance between flight time or performance depending on the next leg of the circuit. Speeders will pass around and under each other in close proximity as they race around the circuit. To keep the pilots safe, they will be protected by a virtual force field. Airspeeder utilizes LiDAR, radar, and machine vision technology to prevent mid-air collisions while still allowing for close quarter air-to-air action. A similar force field will be present around the boundaries of the race circuit, preventing any speeders from cutting corners. If they do so, their speeder will be automatically speed limited until it returns to the track, similar to a race car that runs over the edges of the tarmac. We do not rely on the creation of large-scale infrastructure because our racetracks are defined digitally. An array of cameras on the ground, in the air, and onboard the speeders themselves will ensure that every moment is captured and streamed to a global audience. We are excited to bring you the future of motorsport in the not-too-distant future. Thank you.